You know, with the number of times that I've slid under an ATV to try to bolt things on, I don't know why I never thought about doing this. Now, if you're going to do this and do it in your shop, it's really best, of course you have to have help, but do it outside first, because turn the fuel off, stand it up, and then you're going to get the float bowl drain. Then you can roll it back in your shop, do it, and you're not going to get anything on your floor. Now, you know, first I guess I better explain. We chose the Rubicon. I jokingly said, you know, Rubicon for the ranch, rancher for the ranch. It just had the right sound. I really liked the idea of grabbing one of the Polaris we have, because they have the from low to reverse shifter, so that you just real easily, when you're plowing, you know, you go low, plow, reverse, and that's really a good feature for plowing. And that's probably around the ranch the main thing I do with the ATV. But I, you know, the smoothness of a Rubicon is just awesome, and I want to see how that transmission holds up to that abuse of pushing a plow all the time, because I'm constantly working on the roads around here on the ranch. So now what we've got is kind of a dilemma here. We've got some stuff. We've got the Cycle Country QuadBoss plow with the electric lift. Now, you don't have to have the electric lift. A manual works pretty good, but electric just makes things easier. They sent us the big, what they call the state plow. This is the big plow. This is probably the best for pushing a lot of nice, fresh snow. I had two problems with it. One is the main thing we do around here now is push dirt. And call me a silly Californian, but this state orange and my yellow Rubicon just weren't going together. I requested a green Rubicon, so anything would go with it, but I didn't get it. So this is what we're going to do. We got the stealth exhaust, and we're going to try to figure out what we're going to do with tires. But, you know, we'll have to see once we get there, because we've got several different tires that we could put on this. The first thing we got to do is bolt this somewhere right here. This is the universal mount. Once this gets bolted on with these U-bolts there and to the skid plate mount right there, then this is the only thing plus the electrical that stays on the ATV, so you can quickly disconnect the electrical and the plow and be able to use this for errands and running around trail riding. Okay, so let's get the tools I'm going to need to put this on. And you know something's American made when you got to get metric for one part and SAE for another one. So let me gather up the tools and we'll bolt this on real quick. Okay, now that I got the right tools, we'll remove the ones we need and then put the U-bolts on here. Make sure I got the right sockets. Okay. Now, what's cool and what I really like about one way to judge the quality of a product on assembling it is, I should have got a longer wrench, is that the new bolts that I'm putting in here, I noticed when I got my wrench, even though these are 12 millimeter that are coming out and are metric threading in, they gave us half inch heads. So these will fit right in here, but now we'll use one wrench for all of this. Okay, now once you get these replacement bolts in, I'll leave those loose as we get ready to put these, the U-bolts in. I can't believe how much easier this is, having this ATV set up on end like this. Or do both of them while I'm doing that. And that's the advantage of leaving things loose, because if you go ahead and tighten something down, you're going to have trouble, you know, making things line up. And remember, this is a part that's going to stay on the ATV now. Even when you disconnect the plow, this is the part that's going to stay on when you go trail riding or, you know, riding, it's for me, riding to the post office or the bus stop, that kind of stuff. Okay, now we're all tightened up, ready to drop this down. Where I talked about this part of it fastening together, we'll just pop these out so I don't have to later, because that's where the plow fastens right in here. Now we'll drop this on its wheels, put the plow together. Clear. Remember, the best way to do this is set your back brake when you put that on. Okay, now we can put this together. I'll just put this a little bit of an assembly that's required for this together before we slide it up. It'll make it easier for me because basically this comes pretty much together. You just got to tighten these because the adjusters go in here. That this goes to the adjuster so you can tension the plow, and then the little lock for the angle goes right in here. Now, Cycle Country, QuadBoss do make an electric adjuster for this, but you still got to lock it in and out, so I like the simplicity of this design. So that's what we'll do first, put this stuff together. Okay, we basically got this assembled, so the next step will be to put the electric lift portion on, and that's just going to bolt right here, and then we've got to swage the end of this, so that's it. And we'll just tighten this in place, and we'll be ready to move on. Okay, with that done, we are now ready to hook the electrical part. Before we put the plow or anything else on here, next step is let's put the electrical. Another, don't be intimidated by the wiring because it's really a piece of cake. This piece goes on your handlebar to make the plow go up or down. Then from there, you've just got two sections of wire. One goes back to the battery, one comes up to the plow. The hardest part's not connecting, it's just making sure it runs through the body cleanly, neat, and secure. So let's run this right now. Okay, now I'm going to start this whole wiring process by mounting the switch right up here to the handlebars where it's going to go. You can mount it any place you want, wherever's convenient, wherever's comfortable for you. I like it right up here on the left side. So we'll mount that, then we'll be able to run these wires through. Now remember, this is one of those spots with little tiny things that could easily get dropped and make this whole installation take twice as long. So I'm always trying to be very careful, not be in a hurry when mounting this stuff. And again, I'm going to leave this just a little bit loose so that after I get on the bike, I can adjust it to exactly where it's comfortable for me. Okay, now let's pop this seat off and start running the wiring. And remember, there's no better time to run the wires the right way than the first time. Make sure once you get it underneath here that you run it away from the radiator so that the wires aren't laying on the radiator and anything else that they could rub on that would cause problems. Okay, I think we're set for the front. Now what I'll do is once we get this done is get ready for the plow. I'll zip tie this the length I need it, maybe run it through up here, I think. But we'll wait till we get the plow on before we go any further. Now I'm debating whether to run this over or under the air box here, because I want to run it out of the way to where it's not going to be binding on anything. But yeah, that's the answer. Look at that right there. Now we'll go right to ground and to hot. Perfect. And I'm just going to make sure when I do this that I hold this, even though this is the ground, over to the side so it stays out of the way. Okay, this is exactly how you're going to fasten this to the machine once you get it all hooked up. You know, this is how you're going to hook it and unhook it. Well, it's just these two pins and then the electrical connection. So now I'm going to, well, angle this just right here so that I can do both of these. Now I'm going to tell you, this is usually easier with the plow on because you just drive right up and you're actually on that side, but I'm trying to do this for your benefit. Watch this move. Impossible. Oh, look at that. And he does it. Now, we get this all, once we got that underneath there, you gotta wrap the, depending on which ATV it is, you wrap this a little different way. But once you get that on, this is also part of the disconnect system that slips on here. So this is what will disconnect the cable. But the cable has to go on here. And so what happens is we're gonna put the cable on here at a low position and then swedge this in place here and hold the cable to this so that when you get ready to disconnect this, actually this will be turned like this, you can just undo this and slide the cable off from, I guess open it all the way. Slide the cable off from that, and that's disconnect and disconnect. But for a measurement, we're gonna leave this on here. Okay, now as I said before, we're not gonna put a state plow on. We're gonna put the regular plow. I just like this plow. This is the one I used on the rancher. I actually just kind of spray painted when it was wearing off. We'll just put this one on, hook it up, because I don't need the extra capacity of that state plow. Okay, now with that on, it's time to do the rest adjustments. Now remember, you got two holes down here, just a little bit ways, you know, an inch apart on where this blade is, and that controls the angle of this blade. The lower the hole, more angle, the higher the hole, less angle. So this is how we want it. The next will be the tension that you can apply to the blade. And by tightening these, you can adjust the tension, because if you get too much on it, it will automatically dump the dirt, manure, snow that you've got. So I want a pretty good amount of tension for dirt, but not too much. So now let's put these on. Now, the last thing we gotta do, we got those on. Tighten this tension a little bit, and now we'll route our cable and zip tie this front portion so it's just right for us to disconnect and connect. Okay, that's got everything fastened in here. Now we're running short on time to try this out. Like I said, I don't have my ATRs. So we have a choice between some mud lights that we had on the rancher, two different size 589s. I think even though they're not on the latest wheels, we'll put the smaller 25-inch 589 MSs on it. We'll be right back. Okay. Now for the best part. Let's go try it out. Let's go plow. See if this baby plows.